sisters are older than me, so they were already on sale, I would say. Like, that's why we moved out. My older sister was around 17 and 18, so there was a lot of people asking for a hand and threatening my dad because they wanted my sister. And so they'll be probably the same price. Since I'm young and you're virgin and whatever, then it'll be probably like, let's say $5,000. And if the guy doesn't have money, he would offer his land or cows or sheep. Most of the time it's older guys, like in the age of 40 and 50, marries like 15-year-old girl, which is pretty horrible. At night, on your wedding night, they put a white material underneath the woman. So if that material is red, the guy takes it in the morning to the girl's family house and then says, "We have accepted your daughter as my wife." If that cloth is not red, then, like, there's no blood, then they give the daughter back and they say she's not a virgin. I had a friend, she was 15-year-old, and she was marrying an old guy. So she's never seen his face. All she heard was about his age, and he's about 45. And she was so scared because he already had a three wives. So obviously when she gets married to this guy and go to the house, the three wives would like put pressure on her and make her do work. And if she cooked something that they don't like, they would beat her up. So it was pretty horrible thing. So she was really scared. And then she got married. She was refusing to make love with her husband because she was too scared. And after a while, I didn't see her again. She left to another village. I don't know what happened to her. Now I've moved into Thailand. I've lived here for about 6 to 7 months, and I love it so much because this is the first place in all my life that I felt home. Sometimes I'm proud, but most of the time I'm ashamed, because everywhere I go, when I say I'm from Afghanistan, they look at me in a weird way, like, oh my gosh, like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, to travel to places, it's just so hard. And when I was in high school and I told people that I'm from Afghanistan, like, my friends would make fun of me, that, oh my gosh, you probably have a bomb in you. And I'm like, not everybody's like that. So most of the time, I'm ashamed of it.
Is she a typical Afghan girl?
No, she isn't a typical Afghan girl, but I tell you, there are probably thousands, if not tens of thousands, of Afghan girls that would be like her if they had the opportunities that she has and if they were given freedom. And she's just a lucky girl that happens to be able to be herself and not have all the constraints of society and religion and culture.
I like to do for fun dancing. So I love belly dance, I love salsa, I love tango, so I mix everything, and like my free time, most of the time I dance. So yeah, I love to dance. If I had my dream job, it would be to become an actress. I think that would be an awesome job in the world. Well, that's what I would be. It's my first time coming to Thailand and seeing the beautiful ocean. And like today, everybody was swimming. I was so scared to get in the ocean because the waves were like so big. So I was scared it's gonna take me away. But Nate was like, "It's okay, you can get in the water." So I was like putting my toes in first, and then I got in the water. It just felt so good. I just love it. And the fish I saw was like, wow, I saw angel fish. And in real life, I thought it doesn't exist, but it was amazing. And like those crazy things I saw, those plants, and it was just so beautiful. I love my Uncle Nate because he saved our lives. He brought us from a dark life to a bright life, full of opportunities to do whatever we wanted. So he's the best uncle I've ever had.
She looks up to you like a hero. How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel proud. I'm really proud of what has been done. I'm proud that they're out. I'm happy she's free. You know, that just makes me happy. It makes me happy to see her running around. And